Hello there. In today's video, I want to talk a little bit about tripods. More specifically, I have a new tripod and I want to show you what it is and one of the genius parts of it that I've taken from Thomas Heaton. First and foremost, I'm replacing this tripod, the old trusty Genesis C5. It's been starting to fall apart on me. I can't close one of the legs, and let's see, I think it's this leg. Completely falls out. So, yeah. It was time for a replacement. So, first and foremost, let me show you what I've got. It's a Leofoto Ranger LS323C. And it's a three-section tripod with a 32mm diameter at its thickest. I think that is what it stands for, and the C is that it's carbon fiber. The tripod gets high enough for me. I'll show you more about the tripod itself soon. First, the really important thing that I want to show you is the head. As I said, I got inspired, or I took the idea from Thomas Heaton. If you've watched his channel, you'll have seen the head setup that he uses. And I'm using something very similar to his, but a little different. And I wanted to talk through why I decided to go with a head like this and the really genius part that I think of it. For those of you who haven't seen, let me show you. The first thing is that the base, or on the spider of the tripod, the top part here, I have a leveling head that sits on top so that I can level it perfectly. And the way that I usually, or I'll talk you through the way that I usually work the tripod later, but I can put it in perfectly level there. And then I have this two-way head on top that just control two axes. So I have the pan and I have the tilt, and that is all that I can control with the head. Now I want to show you, I want to demonstrate the way that I would use this tripod and what really is the genius part of it. So let's do that. So first and foremost, the tripod it's a little bit larger when it's packed down. It's a little bit larger than my backpack, but I prefer having fewer sections since it's quicker to work in the field. So the way that I usually use the tripod now is I usually have a rough idea of the scene that I want to photograph. I've scouted out a composition that I want. So I've indicated somehow where I want to place it out. Then I quickly want to get the tripod out so it has nice quick locks that opens up completely with just a quarter turn, which is really nice. So let's just put it down like here, and as you can see, if I just max it out, it is not exactly as tall as I am, but it's as tall as I would or can use a camera. It's actually a little bit uncomfortable for me to use a camera at this height. Sure, I wouldn't mind if the tripod went up to like here for certain situations, say if it's uneven and I want to get higher up. But yeah, it's a trade-off that you have to do with weight and everything, and I find this to be a nice trade-off for me at least. Anyway, let's set it up like this. The way I usually do it is that I tilt the head down, unlock the base, and then I find the the point where it's completely leveled. Then I can screw the camera on here, and I can then use it almost as a ball head, except that I have no tilt available to me. And the nice thing about that is that I can focus completely on the two movements that I really want to control, and that is the pan and the tilt. And say I've dialed in the amount of tilt that I want for the scene, perhaps. Then I can lock that, and then I can just control the pan to dial that in properly without having to alter the tilt, and especially without having to alt the rotation axis. So that is just a genius way of simplifying the workflow. It adds a little bit of time in the workflow. It's a little bit slower to get everything set up, since I need to push it down and then level it out here beforehand, and then I can start to point the camera. So it adds a little bit of time in that sense, but it's very small amount of time for what I'm gaining. What I was actually considering was getting something like a geared head or something like that. If you watched any of Adam Gibbs' videos, you know he's been using geared heads, and he's talked a lot about how it slows you down and makes you think and dial in the composition more in the way that you really want the composition to be. You'd think more about it, and I really like the way that he's been talking about that, and I was thinking about that for myself. But there are two reasons why I don't want a geared head. Number one, they are heavier. Number two, they might be too slow. If conditions change quickly, you still want to be able to adapt kind of fast, even if you're not able to adapt as fast as a ball head. So this, in a sense, gives and in between the two, it gives the control of the axis, even if it isn't the fine control, but it gives you the control that if you want to just use the pan, or if you just want to use the tilt. And that is something that a ball head is very lousy at. So that was the thought behind getting this particular head. And I was hesitating a little bit whether or not I should actually get it. I was thinking, it might not be working out as well as I was hoping. But let me tell you, that it's been wonderful. I've been loving this just so much. And let me show you one more thing that it gives you, a possibility that it gives you. Let me just grab my camera. So then, the other genius thing about it is panoramas. It simplifies the use of panoramas quite a lot. Say that I want to capture a panorama. Then what I'm going to do, tilt the camera down, unlock the leveling head, make sure that the bubble level, which is in the center there, is centered, and now I have a completely leveled platform, no matter how uneven the tripod is. So what I can do now is, well, the simple thing is just a simple pan of the scene, but let's say I want another row, then I can tilt it down like that without changing any pan or changing any rotation. So I'm just changing the tilt, and then I can do another row. So yeah, that's kind of simple. But one thing that is really hard to do with a ball head is a vertorama. So a panorama, a vertorama, it's vertical. So it's not a panorama, it's a vertorama. So that means taking a sequence of images from below up, right? And with this kind of ball head, or not a ball, with this kind of head, it's really easy to do. I can simply unlock it, take an image, move it, move it, move it. And I'm not changing the pan at all. So I have very good control of what in, or I have very good control of the way that I control the camera. So it gives me very fine control without slowing me down too much. So I think that is really a brilliant idea. I don't know how well Thomas has actually explained everything, but when I first saw his tripod, I thought it was unnecessary and a way to seem more clever than it actually was. So I never actually considered it for myself. Until I started to think more about gear heads as a way to fine-tune my compositions in a better way. And then I thought, well, this might not actually be a bad idea, and it isn't. It's actually a really, really clever idea. So thank you, Thomas, for showing us all. And if you've been thinking about getting something like this for yourself, know that it's a very fun way to shoot, and it gives you more control, and yeah, it's just really, really fun. So yeah, that's about it. If you have any questions about the specifics of the tripod, or the head, or the leveling head, or any of that, I'll leave a link below what everything is named, and you can check it all out if you feel like it. So if you've enjoyed this video, remember to give it a like. If you want to see more, especially how I'm using it in the field, remember to subscribe and check out my other videos on my channel. I have tons of content. I think the last 3 videos on my channel I've been using this setup, this tripod and this head. So yeah, leave a comment if you have any questions, and I'll see you all soon again. Until next time, goodbye.